Great.
So, good afternoon, friends. Very warm welcome to you, and a good afternoon to you all. And hope you and your family are doing fine. It's a very challenging time. So, let me welcome you on behalf of PeopleBridge. We are a premier digital and HR consulting firm serving clients in India and abroad. To call the present time as stressful is surely an understatement, as this is probably the greatest challenge of our professional and personal life. So diet plays a very important role in managing our health, both mental and physical. And there is no one better than Renu Puri to advise us on the same. Ms. Puri has done her master's in food and nutrition. She has started her career in software training, but her true calling was in wellness through diet. What started as a friendly advice to colleagues and family soon turned into her life's mission. Over a period of nearly two decades, she has helped thousands of her clients transform their life through diet. What has really helped her in her drive for quality and passion, which means not diluting the brand by franchising the clinic in every nook and corner. Each client receives a personalized attention from her very well-trained and equally passionate member of her dietly team, and their clientele is spread across many countries like USA, Australia, Dubai, China, Hong Kong, Switzerland, etc., to name a few. Many of their clients in third cities like Jalalabad and many more have taken full advantage of their diet counseling through phone calls and WhatsApp or email. And they are very adept at handling the clients with the health issues. So without taking too much of time, I hand over to her for this session. For your queries, please type in them in the chat box and we shall try to answer them to the extent possible. Thank you all. And I'm just handing over to Mr. Renu Puri for the session.
Thank you, Amitabh.
And welcome you once again. Yeah.
Thank you. Welcome, everybody. I'm going to share my screen. Hello, everybody. Like Amitabh just said, this would be the understatement to say that we are undergoing quite a challenging time. And here we are going to touch only one facet of this challenge, that is the relevance of diet, even the diet consideration. A lot of people I hear, even our continuing clients, they ask us, seriously, do you want us to consider right now what to eat? My answer would be, we are eating, right? If we are eating, then yes, all the time we need to be on top of it that what we are eating. In this particular webinar, I'm not going to get into biochemistry or vitamins, minerals, the detailing of nutrients, so to say. I'm going to handle it at a more how you present it level, how you prepare the meals, what are the precautions, what are the additions, deletions, modifications you can bring about, both in terms of food items, food preparation, and the meal, how you can plate it, all that which we are doing on our day-to-day basis anyways. So as you can see, I'll be touching upon issues like what are the manifestations of lockdown on our routine, and then I'll give you some tips on all these things, how to preempt hunger, what to keep ready for those frequent hunger pangs, single bowl meals, how can they help us, the batch cooking, if it is the need of the hour, how to go about it, what is the best way to inculcate that in your cooking, I will say methodology, what are the essentials which you have to have anyways, what role does hygiene play in all this, what are the tips for food presentation. I'm also going to discuss stuff like what you consider, is it a veggie or is it a staple, and then hidden calories in the food. All these things I'm going to deal with one by one. First of all, manifestation of lockdown. This is a no-brainer. The ones who were going to gym are not able to do that. The brisk walkers, the ones who were going for yoga classes to various studios, aerobics, Zumba, we are not able to do it, and for very good reason. I'm recommending let's not do it. At the same time, we are also succumbing to very indulgent food. We are seeking almost like comfort in that food. more than ever before, despite the fact that the home deliveries, they have really been clamped down. Variety is not an option. And of course, women, the universal crusaders, they have to adapt to whatever else everybody in the family is wanting or eating or showing a preference for. I encourage my clan to come up and really take care. This is a time to be very empathetic. Be empathetic to one and all. Begin it from your own self. Most of us now are operating from home. So you must have noticed, despite the fact that we keep hearing that, my workload has increased working from home, but somehow the hunger pangs are more frequent than they used to be when we were operating in offices. Now, maybe one of the reasons is that there is a whole lot of food choices available us being at home. But the big question is, are those healthy options? How to ensure that when we succumb to those frequent hunger pangs, we are not the victim of last minute meal decision demon? How? Basically, you preempt it. You preempt and you prepare. Now, you'll say, as it is, I'm cooking the whole day. Do you want me to cook some more snacks and all? Anyways, when we are eating at the last minute, we are opening a packet. That packet can be, the packet of namkeen can be diluted, with kuchumar salad to turn it into a bhel. You can, while you're doing other cooking in the kitchen, you can simply hang some curd in muslin cloth or cheesecloth. And we just call it Greek yogurt, or we call it a hung curd that can be used as salad dressing, that can be used as a spread for sandwiches. In fact, it can be used as a snack by itself. You can just add some finely chopped onion and tomatoes, cucumber, bell peppers to it, and voila, you have a very healthy snack available. And of course, there is a whole lot of option of making namkeens at home. You can use makhanas, age-old makhanas. If you have, everybody has at home those cereal boxes. Those cereal boxes can be converted into very, very, very healthy namkeens. We don't have to be opening those bad oil quality namkeens which we get ready-made. You do keep ready your medley of seeds. Seeds are a very good snack in between. And I tell you one thing, a secret preemptor, that is the sonf, our fennel seeds. If you immediately after having a big meal, a lunch or a dinner, if you start chewing on a tablespoon of sonf, the chances are you'll tide over your dessert, that need, that inclination, you might tide over that. I would invite you here to share with me, what is your version of homemade namkeen or a snack, a quick snack? I'm just type in your chat box. I would very much, because like I said, it doesn't have to be very exotic. You can just open, of all the things, the namkeen, which I'm discouraging you to use, the straight out of the packet namkeens, even those, if you use not more than 1/5 of the entire snack, you can turn that into a good one. Okay, Meenal says my voice is breaking. I'll try to take care of that concept. So, chirva and peanut roasted with very little oil, that's a very good idea, yes. So which means that we have to have chirva, murmuras, this stuff ready. I'm getting very good ideas, pohas with multigrain flour, chili powder, peanuts, yes, oats. Another very good idea. On oats, I will say it's better if you, rather than using the instant oats, if you have some, steel cut or diamond cut oats boiled and kept in the fridge. You can cook them in a way that you can later on turn it into a namkeen. Wheat flakes and chana. Guys, I'm getting very good These are very good suggestions. Moving on. The next tip for these challenging times I would share with you is a single bowl meal. When I say a single bowl meal, don't think of something which has to be very complicated recipe. And it can be a fusion meal. It can be hot or cold. To begin with, its biggest advantage is that it will take some monotony out of your regular meal style, your regular Indian fare. And when I say a single bowl meal, I don't mean just the bowl, the meal which is served in a single bowl. I also mean the meal which is cooked in a single vessel. I'll very quickly share one single bowl recipe with you. Here you can see I have put all the ingredients. This whole video is available on my YouTube channel if you want to check it out later. So in this particular one, I have tried to appease both the vegetarian and non-vegetarian eaters. So there are pre-sorted veggies. There is quinoa and rice. Normally, even for my personal use, even if I feel like having those traditional meal combos like rajma chawal, kadi chawal, I normally go half and half on quinoa and rice. Believe me, if you do that for your family, most of the times they can't even tell there's any difference in the rice. You can, or if you think they're very, very perceptive, especially since we have more time at hand these days, try and go 25% quinoa and 75% rice. It will inculcate a new taste into them since quinoa is high in protein. And then you see, I have put, I'm using two pans, one for chicken and one for paneer. Simply sorted the two, chicken and paneer, into separate ones and added half and half quinoa and rice. Just the amount of water that we use anyways to boil rice. Voila, your single bowl meal is ready. One meal, one container to cook it and one container to serve it. Here, once again, I invite your participation in what you think can be a single bowl meal. You know, like I said, it doesn't have to be something very exotic or something very, you know, complicated, requiring difficult to tell, to get ingredients. Ingredients, like we said, are anyways more and more, you know, less and less available these days. Our sweet old khichdi is a single bowl meal. All you have to do in these days, just to make sure that your family eats not only rice and dal, you can add maybe some granular millets into it. You can add a whole lot of veggies. To my question, I'm getting very good answers. Rice and curd. Sprouts with murmura, chili powder, dalia with curd, dal khichdi. Yeah, there you go. Dal khichdi with quinoa, bhel puri, bulgur wheat with veggies, upma pohe. I'm getting very good response. I can see that my audience is already very, very aware about what they are eating. And that's a good kind of audience to have. I'll put it like this. Anything that you can think of which were traditional, something like a rajma chawal, I keep coming back to it. It's a very, very, very popular dish in my household. I tend to just add veggies to that. You add veggies to it, call it whatever you want to call it. And then you have a complete meal. After saying about single bowl meal, here's a tip. This tip is called batch cooking. That batch cooking, okay, by batch cooking, I don't mean the batches of people cooking the food together. What I mean is that the food items or the dish is as whole or in part can be cooked for more than one meal. We all know that onion, tomato, ginger, garlic, that curry, it's used in 90% of our curry dishes. How about this, that next time you pull out your food processor for grinding this, you don't prepare it just for that one meal. You prepare it maybe for 8, maybe 10 meals. You know, it's only marginally more time it's going to take if you're preparing it multiple times more. You can prepare that. Let it cool. And here's a good idea. You can, of course, put them in small glass containers in the freezer or else to make it very convenient for future usage, you can put it in an ice cube tray. Once frozen, just pull out those cubes, put them in a Ziploc and put them away in the freezer. Whenever you're ready to prepare a dish, just pull out maybe 2-3 of those cubes. Voila, you have the curry ready and just make anything out of it. This sort of thing, not only for lockdown period, even when, you know, both the partners working and all, I would encourage you to inculcate these habits that maybe on weekends, maybe on one day, which is more more easily the time is available and you can do cooking for a longer while, get into batch cooking. There are tons of ideas for batch cooking. You can parboil even rajma, chane. You can keep quinoa ready all the time to make a very quick quinoa pulao out of it. It's a very good idea to saute veggies separately and then put them away in the fridge. In fact, veggies like mushrooms, anyways, you should, when you bring them home, you should not keep them like by themselves in the fridge. You need to clean it and saute it and keep it away. It really works on the life. That batch cooking could be for anything. Again, I'm inviting your ideas. What can you prepare in batches? When I say batches, I mean in bulk quantities. Because, you know, like I said, it can be in any format. It can be for breakfast. It can be a complete dish, or it can be a dish which is part of the whole meal. It will help you in, you know, being halfway there. Like I said, that supposing you're making rajma, you have boiled rajma, it's a very good idea to take out a small glass container of rajma and keep it aside. It's a very good addition for salads. Every time you don't have to have only the greens and the veggies and some fruits, you can throw in some boiled rajma. Comes out really good. Any other idea? Or am I the only one who's doing the batch cooking and putting things away? Absolutely, Mona, you're right. We can add onion, tomato, and, you know, we can make a paste. And half the times the people don't use their food processors because they think that, oh, who's going to clean all those, you know, attachments and this thing just for one meal. But if you take it out and you're using it for slicing, chopping, cutting, and, you know, so much. Risha, maybe not besan laddu. Maybe not when we are doing the batch cooking here, because we are talking more in the form of how to up your nutritive value in this thing. I'm going to stick to non-indulgent food. And where I'm trying to help you is everybody has to cook anyways. It's not that you can stop cooking because the times are very challenging. You have to cook. So how to make your cooking less challenging? A marinade for tikkas is an excellent idea. Actually, if I share something with you, normally in my fridge, when the chutney is about a day or so old and, you know, it has lost its charm, I try to just let the water out. And that itself, if you add a spoon of hunker to it and just put whatever extra masalas you want to, it makes very good marinade. So chutney leftover doesn't go waste. And of course, you can make it from the beginning. Tomato puree, excellent idea. Because a lot of time we take a very long time in preparing, dehydrating the tomatoes when we are cooking. Yes, I'm getting very, very good ideas. Moving on, even if it's essential time, the health, the body, the requirements, they are not in lockdown. You need to be on top of the game when it comes to eating well. You know, a lot of, I'm not, again, like I said, I'm not going to get into the chemistry of it, but the lot of nutrients, they are water soluble and your body excretes out the excess on daily basis, which means you need to replenish yourself with them for every 24 hours, just like your vitamin C. So regularly, broadly speaking, make sure you have curls. It's a very, very natural probiotic. Make sure you have curds, raw vegetables, fruits, milk, and lemon or any citrus fruits, very, very good, like, you know, for your vitamin C requirement these days. Garlic, ginger, these are our detoxification agents. They are lying right in our kitchen cabinet. And it's not that it has to be that those things have to be, you know, boring, oh, let me finish this part and then I'll come to my main meal. Of course, they can be inculcated within your other meal choices. Guys, I cannot overstate the requirement of sanitation these days. You have to ensure that the vegetables, especially the excess one that you've been buying these days, it's really kept well. Because last thing you want is have an upset stomach or have any kind of other infection in GI tract or your throat getting sore. That's the last thing you want. You don't want to add to complication to already a very challenging environment. Try and keep the stuff in a sequence where you know that you're going to use it. That's one of the things. This is where I get a lot of resistance when I say tips for food presentation. And people are saying, actually, are you serious? Isn't it enough the food is being prepared? You want it to be presented also? You know, food is a huge, huge motivator in bringing people to a better mood, wherever they are, in de-stressing them. I will say, personally, I feel it takes only 2% more time to present a food well vis-a-vis the amount you of time you took to prepare it. Go for it. Go for very, very simple hacks. Just keep some chutney ready, papad. So that ready salad, maybe sprinkle some nice herbs on top of ready food. Maybe julienne of ginger. It's anyway need of the hour. Even if you don't have fresh herbs, fenugreek, whatever is there in your cupboards, just use it now. Little bit. Use better dishes. It does matter how you're presenting the food. Now, this is a pain point for a lot of people. I hear this concern pretty often. People say, you know, I've been eating only boiled food. How come boiled veggies? How come I'm still gaining weight? And you know what they're calling veggies? They think potatoes, sweet potatoes, colocasia, arbi, sweet corn. These are veggies. I do agree and I appreciate your cooking method that you've gone for steamed or boiled. You've chosen recipes which are not into deep frying or batter frying, which is truly bad for our GI tract. But what you have chosen is not a veggie. You got to know that these are the staples. And when we are having the complete meal, we need to calibrate which food item is giving what kind of calories. Do we have protein, carbs? Now people will have a bowl full of sweet corn. They'll say, oh, this was steamed. We had it in the mall. On the way, maybe from a vendor, they will have, sand roasted corn on the cob and they'll come home and eat proper food, thinking maybe once you've had that, you've had your staple in the form of corn. How about coming home and having only dal, veggies, and some curds maybe? Even if you don't do that, even if you still insist, I must have my roti or my rice or quinoa, be aware that you've had maybe one or one and a half more rotis than your usual this thing. So these do's and don'ts, be aware of them. Whether you follow them or not, mindfulness plays a huge role. I'm now coming to the content part. These are the options, food options that I'm talking about. I'll not go much into the detail of what ragu should be having, but there are certain concoctions depending upon individual conditions. Dhaniya ajwain water, it's very good for body cleansing. Haldi water, you know, it has anti-inflammatory and analgesic effect. Sonf ajwain water, methi water, kari patta water. These concoctions that I'm speaking about, they are best had first thing in the morning. Certain, I will call them nutritious breakfast options. I'll just read them out. They are milk and fruits, poha, upma. You know, you may say that, okay, I anyways eat poha, upma, dal chila. What's the new thing you're talking about? New thing is, I would encourage you that when you're making poha, even in my own household, when my son was growing up, if he would ever ask for Maggi, my precondition to him used to be that I'll give you Maggi, but the veggies and the paneer amount of it, which I'm going to saute and put in the Maggi, has to be double the amount of Maggi. And with that kind of arrangement, we used to agree on this thing. So if you're having only poha, like I said, you need to calibrate which part, which kind of food group your calories are coming from. If they are coming only from easy carbs, you are asking for trouble. Going for lunch, you can choose any of the, you know, light grains, jawar, and you have, you know, jaw, bran roti. By bran roti, I mean you're adding wheat bran, and or you could choose maybe brown rice, any kind of dal, idli, plain dosa. These are the options. You know, a lot of people think going on diet means you can't have dosa, you can't have, you know, pulao and all. No, that's not true. In the evening, the options could be with chai, coffee, like we just said in the beginning, that you could have some very healthy snack options. You gave me a whole lot of new ideas as well. So keep it ready. And when I say bhel, biscuit bhel, I mean the right kind of biscuit, and that to be used in place of those small mutteries that we use otherwise in the bhel. Dhokla, hunkered with fruits, mixed seeds, all these pumpkin and sunflower seeds, chia, flax seeds. You can make a medley of them anyways with kids at home. Inculcate the habit of adding these seeds. You can add them even to soups or dahi, salad, even in your curries, you can add them. Why have them just like that with a glass of water that, okay, I'm done with it? No, make them part of your meals. For dinner options, you could choose vegetables. Of course, whole lot of them. It could be a soup, vegetables, spinach, tomato soup. You know, with changing weather, some people may not like to have hot soup. Just let it cool down outside, put it in the fridge. Voila, you have gazpacho ready. All that it means is it's a cold soup. You could have dal, chicken clear soup, quinoa roasted cutlets one can make, grilled fish. Because for dinner, we should be going slightly lighter. I'm quickly going to go through a few sample diets. In the morning, for one person, though it is extremely individual. I can't be saying everybody on the webinar, okay, this is the diet you should have. There could be certain issues or certain situations or certain conditions in a person. Something could be as simple as maybe the person develops a lot of flatulence by having a particular food item. All those have to be considered when we plan individual's diet. But as a sample, healthy water and have tea and three walnuts in the morning, then have some seeds with water. You know, like here we have mentioned, have some seeds. Maybe those seeds you don't have first thing in the morning. You can add them to your breakfast where you made a very nice poha. You could add it there. And then again, do have some small thing mid-morning. Don't try and bring a huge gap between two meals. A huge gap is very recommended between dinner and breakfast, all right, but not otherwise. Don't let your body go into the mode where it is asking for a very high calorie intake. Again, the other sample diet has different kind of water. Like I said, it varies from person to person. What's your requirement? Breakfast can be dalia from oats, groats. This is where I'm bringing all those batch cooking and that kind of stuff together. The oats groats will take as much time as rajma or chana does. Even steel cut and diamond cut oats, you have to have oats. Unless there is an emergency, I would not recommend quick oats. These have to be boiled and kept in a glass container in the fridge. Once they are there, you're making early morning breakfast. Just use them to make your cereal bowl and put any amount of very nice fruits, or if you want to have a savory kind of breakfast, you can make a chila or a dalia with lots of veggies. Then jeera water, depending upon what's your requirement. And then here you can see, just milk and fruit. How much you need to eat. This is another sample diet. And in lunch, you have a regular roti and sabji, raita. As you can see, the diets being designed are pretty close to what we would be eating anyways. And also, when you go out for vacations and all, you guys should not be thinking in terms of, oh, I can't be dieting these days. I can't be on diet. No. Diet counseling, in single word, means whatever the available options are, what is the most optimum choice you can make out. So even for lockdown period, I will say that if there was one time, any time one needed the diet counseling, it is now. With lesser choices, you need even more counseling to choose just the right thing. You have to preempt the hunger pangs. You have to keep the right selections ready. And don't go crazy about cooking. Please do inculcate the habit of batch cooking. Like I said, either the entire dish or dish in parts. Especially the dishes which take a lot of time, like our masala chana, like rajma, and these like koftas, which take a long time in cooking. You must prepare them for more than one time. Use very nice glass containers, freeze them. It remains okay. That's my personal experience. Do make right choices. Don't confuse, oh, this is veggie. What is not veggie is not a veggie. Amitabh, at this point, I would invite their questions. And personally, I would say that diet counseling is nothing but trying to help a client to modify a pattern which he or she has taken years to set in. Also the newer patterns should be sustainable over a very long period. As dietitians, we impart the tools to do it. That empathy has to be there, lockdown or no lockdown. Somebody who's trying to work on the patterns, I personally believe patterns in form of sanskaras, they actually last over more than one birth time. So you have to, in a very gentle, in a very positive way, you have to seek help and understand the underlying effort which is going towards it. Guys, I'm putting this slide, which is our contact slide, on top. You can, of course. And I'm inviting your questions. We have Amita, please go ahead.
Yeah, so ma'am, one person has requested, the initial slide where you talked about the food items in the beginning.
The slide where I said, which one? What all to keep ready?
Yeah. Which listed the food items in the beginning.
Okay. I will go back to that. Yeah. I have a question. People are saying the persons who have difficulties digesting milk product, what should be a good source of calcium? Rupal, here I will say one thing. Whenever, and I have a lot of clients coming to me saying, we are allergic to milk protein, we can't have casein. My thing is, first, I definitely rule it out. Because when you say you can't digest it, sometimes people just think that because they have flatulence, because they have the stools which have gone slightly softer after having milk or milk products, maybe they can't digest it. First, I try to give them ideas how they can up their digestion of milk products. Otherwise, if they can't, there is a huge list of stuff that can replace those milk products. That's really no big thing. What can be, Nishima says, what can be changed in diet to move those stuck weight? Nishima, I'll answer that question in a single sentence. It's your dietary pattern. You go online today on internet, you will have n number of content, diet samples, which people will give to you. Why is it that you are not able to follow the philosophy? Why? Do accept the fact that patterns don't get changed very easily. There is a reason why counseling is required, and that too in food counseling. We have we since our birth, in our growing up times, we've been brought up, you know, eating in a particular manner, particular style, and the food which used to be only for festivities, they are becoming more and more our daily foods. So yeah, the pattern needs to be modified. That's what we do to address the stuck weight.
And I think there's a question from Harish. He wants to know what to avoid chip and junk food.
Harish, yeah, I think you have touched the pain point of a whole lot of
people. He's speaking on almost everyone's behalf, actually.
I would say that. Harish, actually, I don't know if you were there when I was talking about healthy options, healthy snacking options. You know, okay, you also, I'll give you one beginning tip. Start using the hunk curd. That hunk curd, you use that for, you just, you know, buy a very nice whole wheat or rye bread and toast it well. And that hunk curd, you add some seeds, some black pepper, salt to it, and just spread that on that toasted slice. Eat that as this thing. You will any day prefer that to that chips packet. Indigestion and acidity, pragya, this is so common, it's not even funny. I will say that people who come to us, sometimes when we say, okay, if you have health issues, come to us, diabetes, kidney, liver, or cholesterol issues, that may be, or PCOD, that many people come also for acidity. It's that prevalent. And again, I will say it is your dietary habits. It's not only the content. Remember in the beginning, I was giving you idea about water, different kind of waters and all. So there is no one solution. I will say you should, if that's a very, very, if that's your biggest problem in life, go for sonf and ajwain water in the morning. So what you have to do is you have to boil a couple of glasses of water, turn off the gas, put 1/4 teaspoon of ajwain in it and 1 teaspoon of sonf in it, and just keep it covered. In the morning, you may sieve it or have it along with the sonf and ajwain. Have that at room temperature. This will help you a lot. Sushmita says, I travel a lot. Yeah, go ahead.
Ma'am, actually, there is two versions of the same questions. Mm-hmm. So there is a question about, you know, mostly it relates to batch cooking, and people want to know, it is healthy because as it is not considered fresh. And the same variant of this question is, does the batch cooking reduces the nutritional value of the food?
No. Once you have cooked it, and you know what is the process of deep freezing? When you freeze a thing, you are almost, basically, why do we say that don't eat the old stuff? Don't eat the stuff which was prepared day before? Because there is a degradation going on continuous, and that process is stalled, as if, you know, it's put on pause. It's put on pause button when you freeze a thing. If you take it out and thaw it, then it will start again. And here I got a question that, can I take care of my diet along with the workout? Of course, you know, whether you want to work out or not work out is your choice. Anyways, through the diet, we can help you with your muscle toning, with your, you know, excess weight issues or any health issues. Yeah. When it comes to travels, due to my own very, very frequent travels, I realized, and that's probably one reason I'm very, very familiar with tons of cuisines. I realized it's no point going to another locale and looking for your regular dal chawal and sabzis and, you know, curries. Believe me, when you go to a particular country, or even for that matter, particular region, any other region compared to where you're living in India, it's always the best to eat their local fare. But how to eat, what to choose, and what to choose to eat and what to choose to not eat, is something, probably we would be able to guide you better on that. You can trust on that. You can listen to one of my YouTube videos on this, where I have said that don't put your life on side when you are undergoing the diet counseling. Do it along with life. Therefore, you be okay with the range when you're traveling. Of course, with the travels, with the late night, you know, meetings and events, everything. We do accommodate them all. Guys, I so apologize. There are so many questions. I am not able to attend to all of them. I think I did share my contact details. You can, of course, contact us on this. Mahesh is asking suggestions for those with sweet tooth. I think that pretty much is 100% of us. If any of you is not, congratulations. That means you have already attained moksha. Sonf is a very good this thing. You know, anyways, I'm not saying don't eat sweet, but choose the sweets which are naturally sweet, not the ones which you have made by putting tons of sugar, little or more, or sugar replacements. I am not in favor of sugar replacements as well. Even if, you know, maybe you can modify the recipes a bit. Even if you feel like making a kheer, how about making kheer with khajur or prunes, or put a little bit more of your kishmish. Do you know something? I'll share a scientific finding with you, that if you, when a newborn child, for the first 2 years, you don't make the child taste salt or sugar. It's an acquired taste, salt or sugar. The child will never think that there is something like that. We'll eat all the natural stuff, and even the roti, sabji and all, without thinking anything is missing, and is more sensitive to the variation in the taste. Can tell more clearly between, you know, one veggie's taste and the other. Fruits are a very, very good dessert options. I keep coming back to hung curd. In hung curd, you have my word for it. Give it a try. Put some seeds, chia seed, pumpkin seeds, sunflower seeds, and you add maybe finely chop the grapes. Go do some work. Finely chop the grapes. Even, you know, these the dried berries you get, just mix some of that, or for that matter, fresh fruit. Use a banana to make a dessert. You know, if you freeze, especially the bananas which are almost going black, you can put them in the freezer in the frozen form. If you run that with the yogurt or with a little bit of milk, you may think it's a creamy thing you are having. Turns out to be very nice dessert. Just add some more kishmish to it. Guys, do adapt to lower level of sweetness. Do adapt to it. Once you, for example, once I personally had a few decades ago asked somebody, how can you have tea without sugar? And today, if I'm out, and not from the calorie counting point of view, my tongue today perceives sugar in tea as bitter. It's a taste. You're sending a signal to your brain. You have to, like I kept on using the word pattern. These patterns are so deeply engraved. We need to really be in a very professional, but in a very subtle manner, be aggressing them. Addressing them, I'm sorry. Sushmita, I just addressed the question about travels. Travels pretty much are taken care of. In fact, during the travels, we can even be telling you what are the better stuff to be, despite your, you know, any of the issues, if it's a diabetes you wanted to write. We do factor in those issues as well. Food items in the beginning and travel a lot. I have, okay, let me go to the food items.
Ma'am, one question which is there.
Uh-huh.
Too often, because of our, you know, work commitment, and we are, you know, running from one meeting to another meeting, you know, it happens quite a lot. Mm-hmm. And especially the when we are working from home also. Mm-hmm. Sometimes our meals get skipped.
You know, very simple answer is, this is pretty much preempting the thing. If it is happening once in a blue moon, this is quite a different matter. But it is happening at least twice a week. You got to have something ready to make sure that your blood sugar level doesn't dip so much that once you get a chance to eat, you pounce on the most indulgent aspect of the food. You know, there's a range to it. Let's remain within that. So there are a whole lot of options. Like I said, the seeds you can keep in a small Ziploc. Even for that matter, the nuts. Having just maybe four or five, if you have four or five almonds and walnut and or cashew, again, depending upon, I hope, if you don't have any issue against, I mean the health issue. You can have that and they will keep you filled for a long time. The hunkered option is very good. If you can have an apple, there are a whole lot of options. Yeah. Is this the slide somebody wanted? Options of the... So these are for first half of the day and this is for the second half of the day. And these options, thereafter we have used them in the entire meal, kind of showing that how... If you had maybe slightly heavy, again, see, it depends upon your routine. Maybe some people's need is to have a heavy breakfast and leave because they know that for the next few hours, they'll be able to eat maybe a very small snack. And some lot of people I come across, they eat two main meals a day. So this is another thing, how we get them to inculcate, you know, those trace elements, those trace nutrients and the antioxidants into their long gaps. All these are very, very individual solutions.
One question which is there is, and I think a lot of people would have, is a lot of us work in shifts. Mm-hmm. You know, even those who are working from IT, you know, sometimes they end up working late because of the client demand, or even those who are working in BPO sector. Mm-hmm. And even industries also, because they have rotating shifts. Mm-hmm. So they face a lot of challenges because their body clock, you know, goes for a toss.
I understand.
So how do they, you know, manage their food? And what is the things, you know, any tip?
Yes. See, first of all, they have to work with their family to understand that what the family is calling dinner is their breakfast. The challenge comes in most of these cases, they go to office and the main meal is provided for there. There is no generic guidance for that because depending upon what kind of cuisine, what kind of, normally it's a very indulgent kind of option. So we've had certain clients who we were able to help through their health issues while having their office meals. Now, once your body clock, you know, I'm not sitting here and saying, no, you should sleep at 10 p.m., 11 p.m. latest. If your work demands that you are working the whole night, then you have to adapt to a pattern to which you should try and stick even on weekends. Don't keep on giving shocks to your body. Send a message to your body, which is sustainable. The pattern should be in a way you are almost kind of, I will say, you're bringing up your body. You are a person separate from your body. You have to take care of it. You have to take responsibility because this is one body which is going to stay with you throughout your life.
Ma'am, one more question from Savita. She wants to know, can we take, you know, soaked walnut and almond in summer?
In fact, that is how you should be having it, soaked.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
And there was another query related to flax and chia seeds. I mean, do they really help in reducing weight?
You know, if you, like I just said, that some people say we've eaten so much, you know, boiled potatoes and corns and all, how come I'm not? I can't say that because somebody is eating flax seeds and chia seeds, they will reduce weight. I need to know what else are they doing or not doing. You know what I mean? Yeah. Yeah. But yes, if you have chia seeds with a glass of water, or like I said, you could put them in raita and curries in your salads, it kind of gives you certain impetus in the form of that your next hunger pang would be slightly delayed. Be aware of it. it kind of helps you in tiding over those very, very frequent underlines. That is it.
Oh, it's a very interesting question, and I always, you know, wonder about this. Why it is important to soak walnuts and almonds? Why not to have it directly?
Though I said I'm going to go into the biochemistry of it, but tannins are removed, which can be a bit toxic. So here I'm not saying don't have them at all without, but it's definitely in summers. Yeah, it's better to have it like that. You know, Amitabh, there are these are two very different phases. One phase is when and here I'm just talking about weight minus any health issues. One phase is when you're trying to reduce weight. The other phase is when you are maintaining that reduced weight or maintaining the weight which you've been carrying for the past few years, I would say. These two are different phases. So the same food, be the pattern, how the cooking method, the quantities, the sequence, they vary in these two. That's why normally for our program, in the beginning only when a client joins, we always encourage them that whenever you're ready to discontinue the program, at least give us 1 month for maintenance. In that maintenance, we try to bring back. It's a process. You bring back the things you made them discontinue. It is a process. You can't just leave it like that. Because your patterns, which I said took years to settle, they are just right behind, they are, you know, sneaking behind, ready to jump back at you like this. They are right there. They have not gone far away from you.
Ma'am, you've spoken so much about, you know, breaking the pattern. Mm-hmm. As it, you know, got to do with your diet or it is your general approach? I mean, how does it work?
Amitabh, since I'm addressing only diet here, so I am talking about it only, but this is across the platform.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know, normally what we see is only our anatomical body. Yeah. The subtler aspects of our life, is where we store our tendencies, our inclinations and all. And there are zillion factors affecting it. But that's how I keep saying that, how come people just read something on internet and it doesn't work for them? It may work for one person. It is very, very individual. We not only tell them what to do, we also first ascertain what is the tendencies, what is the pattern. In fact, I recall sometimes my team members say, oh, Renu, how to help her? She's such a liar. She says, you're not doing your counseling if the person is not confessing, you know. So it's almost like, I will call it a psychological counseling. Yeah. Modifying a food, eating pattern is, it's a behavioral thing we are addressing.
So ma'am, we are almost out of time. So I will just take one or two questions more. And then we will done. And one person, you know, wants to know how to reduce belly fat.
You know, I think everybody wants to know that. One person has asked. It's not that everybody who's overweight has a belly fat. Can be stored subcutaneously or even on internal organs, which is visceral fat, anywhere in the body. Every person has a particular tendency for a body to store fat. It's just like the way the fat came. Supposing somebody just gained on the back, and then, you know, even then could be wearing the shorts and the legs are looking very slim and there was so much on the belly. And towards the end, after there was more than 25 kgs, then it started coming on the calves and on the thighs also. When the person will start reducing fat, the fat will start going off from where, from the those places where it had come the last. It's just like a wave coming down and going back. That pattern is there. So in nutshell, I'll say, normally, you should not be addressing the spot reduction. But yes, the diet, if supposing that what they were calling belly fat was a resultant of a flatulence or some other issues, maybe they had visceral fat. Again, it's a very individual thing. Looking at the case, one can help.
Yeah, so we are almost done with the question and answer session. And thank you so much for taking time and, you know, speaking to us. And
Anamika, thank you so much.
And, Anamika, if you can just unmute Anamika.
Yeah.
Yeah. And a big thanks to Anamika for curating this event.
Yeah.
And yes, and I hope all of you enjoyed the session and you find it good enough. And there is some takeaway for each one of you in this session. And so this is not actually a session, you know, where we can help, you know, people plan their diet, but it's just to create an awareness. And if you need more information, please, you know, do get in touch with Mrs. Renu Puri for or Karisma Diet Center team for this. Ma'am, can you go back to the content slide, please? Your contact details slide, please.
Okay.
Yeah. So, no, the contact details. So you can see the contact details on the screen, and please get in touch with her if you need more information. And thank you once again, Mrs. Puri and Karisma Diet team, and also Anamika for putting this together. Thank you once again. Have a nice day.
Everybody,
please connect with us for more.
Stay healthy and stay happy.
Thank you so much.